What we did in this paper is to try to solve a very old debate of neuroscience, which is the role of the peripheral nervous system and the central nervous system, how these two systems interact to generate locomotion and to control and sustain locomotion. And for this, we use a robot that is a lamprey. And with this lamprey, we will be able to sense the environment and bring these signals of the sensing of the environment to the central nervous system and complement each other.
Agnetax is an undulatory swimming robot composed of 10 segments along the body. Each of the segments has a motor that allows us to do side-to-side movements, and additionally, it has a sensor unit on each of its eyes to measure the force between the environment, which in this case is the water, and the robot. According to the controller we were testing, we loaded a program into the robot and made it swim in a pool. Our pool is equipped with a motion tracking system that allows us to quantify the results of the movement to later compare them with our expectations.
We found that the central and the peripheral nervous system together produce robust locomotion. And using both systems at the same time helps to be robust against neural disruptions, like, for example, communication failures between segments, muted sensors, or muted neural oscillators. We also found that peripheral force sensors in the skin of the animal and the robot that sense how much the water is pushing against the body were very useful signals to generate locomotion patterns. It confirms that there are important functions of the peripheral nervous system that are hidden by the central nervous system.
So this project has two main contributions, one which is for neuroscience, one which is for robotics. The contribution to neuroscience is to explore this key question of how do we generate locomotion and how do we synchronize the rhythms needed for locomotion. The contribution to robotics is really this notion of fault tolerance, being able to resist to big perturbations. Here we have design principles that allow us in principle to be very robust to many, many lesions. We can provide a potential explanation of why animals are so robust to do swimming. And this is really a good idea to take inspiration from animals, and they bring that robustness to robots.